Scheduling is about choosing the order that jobs get done. Specifically, that's the sequence that resources get allocated to the creation or delivery of a product or service. But how do we choose, and how is it so different in different types of operations? Hi there, I'm Lawrence Gartside, management trainer and consultant in business operations management. Check out my courses over at rotanstraining.com. Back to the scheduling. Scheduling is a core part of almost every industry's operations. A car factory has to make customised cars for customer orders. A restaurant has to cook the meals ordered. A customer service help desk has to respond to loads of customer email questions. An ambulance has to choose which emergency to go to next. An Uber app has to decide which customer to pick up next. And a hairdresser has to choose which customer's hair to cut next. The scheduling for some of these seems obvious. But what's curious is how different the obvious answers can be from each other and what rules we use when things stop being so easy. Hairdresser is quite obvious. How does the hairdresser choose whose hair to cut next? Easy. First come, first served. Or they have a booked appointment system, which fill up also on a first come, first served basis. It's easy, everyone understands the system, it's fair, and customers can't get angry. To the hairdresser, finishing one customer's hair is just as good as another. They all pay basically the same. Easy. Scheduling optimised for fairness and simplicity. This is probably usually the same in the restaurant. If your table orders first, you expect to get your food first. But sometimes you don't. You see that other table over there that you know you ordered just before, and they've just got their meal before you. Outrage! Maybe you've got a tardy waiter or the chef doesn't like you. But also maybe the chef was just making a puff pastry beef pie for an earlier customer, saw that the other table had just ordered beef pies too, and he thought he'll make a batch at the same time. So breaking the default scheduling rule of first come, first served kind of makes sense. But now his scheduling rules have got a bit more complex. What was initially just scheduling rules for fairness and simplicity now incorporates a bit of output maximisation, as he's partially accommodating for batching and changeovers. How about an ambulance? Sounds kind of obvious again. There's an emergency call, the ambulance is waiting, so it goes. But what if it's already on its way to one emergency and another call comes in? Well, okay then, if that new one is more serious, then I think we all understand that it makes sense for the dispatcher to divert it and leave the first emergency waiting for someone else to take care of. What if the ambulance has already arrived at the first emergency, already started that job, and then the second, more urgent call comes in? Can you pack up and leave them? That gets real tricky. Typically, I think if an ambulance has arrived and is administering emergency care to someone, then they won't leave and go to a new, more urgent job. It's tougher. The dispatcher literally has to make scheduling decisions that save life and risk death. But this isn't done on how they feel. Along with highly experienced medical assessments, using the available information, they will be working to a very strict, defined set of scheduling rules of how to allocate resources and in what order. So maybe we have to be very careful about when to commit our resources to a job, in case a more urgent, more important, more profitable job comes up. A helicopter ambulance certainly has to make this big scheduling decision. Normal emergency calls are always coming in, and the waiting helicopter, if you're in part of the world where you're extraordinarily lucky enough to have one, the waiting helicopter could get to any of them the fastest. But it won't. Even proper medical emergencies, it will just wait until a very specific type of emergency comes up. Typically only serious trauma emergencies in very difficult to reach places where a normal ambulance would be much, much slower. Using the helicopter is really expensive, and again, if it goes to some normal emergency and then a special emergency comes up, well, then we're stuck. So scheduling decisions with a resource like ambulances, where you are balancing life and death with money and the possibility of another more serious emergency coming up, are really difficult operations management, resource allocation and scheduling decisions. Take away the life and death, and this is absolutely the same kind of scheduling decisions that an operations manager has to make in a factory. Do we set up the special machine to run a quite big customer order now, but then if something, another order that's more urgent or more profitable, if that job crops up, do we stop and create a big chunk of lost changeover time, or make the new job wait and risk the money and customer satisfaction loss there instead? Not easy. As another example, equipment scheduling is another big decision for operations managers in a commercial bakery. The big factory-like bakeries baking tens of thousands of baked goods a day for supermarkets, etc. Here, the orders are probably very, very stable. Customers don't ring 911 and say they need an emergency 10,000 cinnamon rolls. Well, actually, they probably do, but the factory operations manager says no, because he knows the stability of his schedule is so important. But it still needs a schedule and decisions made about the rules on how to create it. Their big trade-off is between batch size, freshness, and lead time. It would be super efficient to make all the whole grain organic bread for the month in one epic mega batch. But after 3 days, it would be stale and unsellable. The supermarket and the customers would all like all the bread baked freshly every hour, but that would cause a ludicrous loss of capacity from the changeovers. So here, the scheduling rules are based off an entirely different set of factors. Every day, you sit down at your desk and make yourself a little to-do list, and then you decide what to do first. You are scheduling yourself. Do you always do the oldest task first? First in, first out? Maybe the shortest job first? You know, tick something easy off to feel good and get the most jobs done in the short term. Perhaps whatever your boss reminded you about yesterday, or what that angry customer was shouting about late last night. Maybe it's the task that will have the most benefit to your company in the long term, or maybe what's best for your own career in the long term. There are really a lot of ways operations managers can choose the sequences of jobs, according to a whole set of different objectives, and they can have a hugely important impact on the overall performance, on output, profit delivery, and customer satisfaction. So even in the simplest of situations, you are always making scheduling choices to optimise for an outcome. Maybe that's ease, simplicity, and transparent fairness with a first-in, first-out system, first-come, first-served. Perhaps it's to get the most jobs completed in the short term by always doing the shortest ones first. Maybe to maximise output in the medium term by minimising changeovers. Or maybe by which customer shouts the loudest. Don't know which scheduling rules you are using? Well, just be careful, because if you aren't scheduling to any rules, chances are you're not optimised for anything. So how do you set your scheduling and job sequencing rules? What are you optimised for, and do you know any of the techniques and heuristics to achieve it? How YouTube sequences what videos it shows to people is one of the greatest secrets of the internet, but clicking buttons of thumbs, bells and subscribe is a big part of it, so if you could help the cause, I'd be delighted. And if you want to learn more about operations management, supply chain, logistics, inventory, performance improvement, watch my next video. Or check out my library of courses on my site, rotanstraining.com. Right then, where are my trousers?